Good morning everybody, Urban Dodger here. Well, today is the 23rd of May and that means only one thing. It's time for the Bushcraft Show. So I'm going to go down this afternoon, so it should be a really good time. The weather's not amazing, but you know, you have to get on with that. And yeah, it'd be really great to see you guys, meet up with you, have a little chin wag and have a brew. So yeah, I can't wait. But yeah, in case you can't see me around, I'll be wearing my Scout Necker. Just an easy way for you to identify me. So come and stop and say hello and have a brew. So anyway guys, best get a move on and I'll see you later. Morning guys, it's a Saturday morning, Bushcraft Show is about to start. So we're just going to get some breakfast on and then head down to the stalls and have a look around. So yeah, catch you in a bit. There's Rick from Big Dog Bushcraft, he's cooking brekkie, it's looking good. Oh, that smells good too. Right, so here we are at the Bushcraft Show, I'm about to go and see all the stalls and check out what's going on. It's really great to be here. I've never been to the Bushcraft Show myself before, so it's going to be a really interesting experience. You know, I've been meaning to go the last couple of years, and each year I've just not been able to for all sorts of different reasons. So this year I was like, make sure I definitely go, and I'm really glad. So the guys I'm staying with, I was really lucky actually to be invited to camp with Zed Outdoors. He invited me to come down. He said we're going to have a big group shelter and set up a parachute, and he said you're welcome to join us and set up with us. So yeah, so big thanks to Zed Outdoors. It's brilliant. So I'm just going to show you around the campsite and see how we've got it all set up. We got it up on Friday afternoon, the parachute. It took a while, but it's a really nice setup. So let's have a look. Right, so here we go. So here's the parachute setup. It's a nice shelter. And then got various tarps and bashes and tent setups over here. We're actually sleeping inside the parachute. It's been dry enough, but we set up the bashes just in case, really, because it has been raining a lot. So we set them up. So let's go in the shelter and have a look. Hey, here's James, Ontario 1986.
My eyes are watering a little bit because of the smoke, but yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty smoky in here. Got a little bit of fire going to keep the mozzies out. So, here's the main man.
How you doing?
Zed Outdoors.
I'm not getting emotional in front of the video, we just got the smoke.
Big thank you to Zed for letting me camp with you this weekend.
It's been a pleasure to have you, man, Dodge.
No, thank you very much.
You've been a very generous guy, assisting us getting this structure up and running and being part of it, so it's a pleasure to have you on board as well, man.
No, thank you very much. Over here we've got Scott from Wessex Blades.
Yeah.
He joined us last night.
Happy years.
And we've got Steve, Sparky Steve.
Hello, boys.
So, yeah, we're just going to get ready and head off to the show and see what it's all about, so catch you in a bit. Right, so here we are, just going to have a wander around, see what's what, have a look. There's Ben Alford's stand.
No, this is just the trouble as well, so.
Sit on if you like, and you're welcome, but please don't stand on it. So if you'd like to come in, that'd be great. Thank you very much.
We've got Beneath the Stars leather craft.
Yeah. What time did you get in?
You know, I got in about five hours, like 2.5 hour journey. 5 hours traffic.
I'm just helping out behind the scenes.
Yeah.
So it's just I met him here at the Bushcraft Show last year.
Right.
And I was on that side of the.
He gave you the sheath, didn't he?
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
I remember.
So yeah. I was on that side.
Yeah. What was this? A hardened blade?
Yeah,
there?
It was a, yeah.
And the cobalt no, wouldn't go through it?
No, it wouldn't get through.
Yeah, fine.
It was a mortar.
Thank you. I know, I haven't stopped all morning. And everyone keeps saying no, you didn't.
Any other questions? I can do. Yeah. Maybe I'll try it. If it's not raining tomorrow, maybe I'll try and record tomorrow's demo. Yeah, fingers crossed. On my YouTube channel, there is a demo of that between the leg splitting technique. Yeah, on snow. So if you want to see it in action on snow, it's there in northern Sweden. Just a final point about safety,
oh, that's what
as I say.
Another one.
I don't generally leave axes lying around like that.
It's
always try and make sure that they're in a stump. There or there. I don't consider that safe. Yeah, because again, there's an edge. You know, maybe being slightly kind of anal about it, but just make sure it's embedded. But don't leave it in there too long. I wouldn't leave it in there overnight because the chemicals in the wood are going to start working on the metal. You're going to blunt your axe. Put it back in the mask, put it away, and it's good to go the next day. Okay, thanks for watching. Appreciate that. And enjoy the rest of your day.
Here's the military mart stall. Massai tribe. Sorry. Okay, so we're back from the main show, pretty damn wet, so we've just come back to camp to dry off, get the fire going a bit and warm up, and I'll turn you around and you can see we've made a Dakota fire pit, and now we're just going to build the fire up and get warm. So there we go. Get that built up, get the place warm again, try and dry off that parachute, but it's absolutely pouring down.
Go to bed,
so it's not as smoky as it was before, but
they're pretty bad. They hold their heat quite well.
Yeah, but you don't want to be wet either.
So if you just set the edge of it, I'll be
just a quick update of the Dakota fire pit. We're being smoked out of the parachute, literally. So we're just going to wait for some flame on the fire to grow
when people come down, back in.
But it's absolutely pissing it down today, and it's not very good. Just been raining non-stop all day.
Cow carcass. I'm going to string it up.
We all know how good these things are. Let's see how useless this is without a proper edge on it. Should jam and never come back out again. That's what I'm guessing. But I've got a bat to get in anyway. So I'll go, if I go there, I've got a chance of going through it.
Hey everybody, look who's joined us. It's Mike from Strat 2206 and he's showing us his brew kit. He's using the Pathfinder Stores bottle and mug set, making a brew.
Yes, it probably is more rugged. It probably is more rugged than this one. But this one's more compact.
Does it nest inside of it?
Yeah, or the whole kit nests apart from the apart from I'm only using trioxin here because I prefer Esbit, but trioxin just takes straight away. It's easy. And I like the fact it's all like shrink wrap, whereas hexamine isn't. It's all in sticks and stitch, and just for a brew, that's getting hot already. It's only been a couple of minutes. So I quite like that.
going to be the old mug, because there's no holes in the sides, like I've got holes in that.
Yeah, the mug is a different, I think it's different generation to the rest of the gear.
Yeah.
The bottle and the mug were bought when, I think these both fetched, and then the other two bits I've just added, so I've only just made the full kit up.
Because the new ones have got the triangle as well.
Yeah,
I prefer those, to be honest.
Yeah, I've only just managed to get the... get the full kit, so, but I bought it because I really like the canteen shop one. Yeah. You know, the one they originally designed, that's perfect for me. For a kind of nesting kit that all goes around your bottle, I wouldn't learn. And at the end of the day, what are you going to do to a stove? You're only going to have that. You're not going to cook anything else on that either, because it's designed for it, and it's handling that bit fine, so I don't see why it moves. You need to use your motor. The only other thing is people say they have more uses than that, which, kind of do, but not really.
You can sort of shove a trans underneath.
Similar from the texture of it. I'm not sure, the only reason I'm saying this is because it's good for cottage. Really good for cottage, but you have to process it quite a lot. It's not something you'd probably be doing here, you know. I'd say it's just, as I say, pull the bark off and taking half the moisture away for a start. It's coming off really easy, but that's because it's spring and the sap's flowing through the wood. It's one thing that, you know, one reason why I kind of believe it could be a willow, but...
Warmer than you want to wear, maybe. Rain in the future.
Well then, ladies and gents, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Scott from Wessex Blades in the parachute, live at the Bushcraft Show on the banjo.
Yeah, I'll be there in a minute. So rusty, to achieve the sound, I've got to play the banjo to make it. I can't remember what the tune is. Yeah. Right, I've got to go.
Yeah, I've got a little mess.
There it is, right? I know I need a D. Yeah. I need a finish. You know, I don't know what to do.
It's almost like it's playing to you, because like, it's recalling your memory. So. Tell you what to play. Just, as soon as you hear your banjo,
once you get to a certain level, like blues guitar, right? What we play? Blues jam, 12 bar in A. So it's going to go A, then it's going to go to D. It's going to go back to A. It's going to go to D. It's going to go back to A. It's going to go to E, yeah. To E to A. But right. So you can just go. You know, that's all you need to do. But you know, when you start, like, you know, it's going to go in G. Well, I know it. That's G. So you start noodling what you're going to do in the chord fret boxes that fit in that, and you sort of noodle your way through it.
Yeah.
But guitar is such a superior instrument. This is a one trick pony. You can do the old one. Here again, I'm trying to remember it. Remember it.
How long have you played that for?
I had 8 months of lessons.
Hey guys, so this morning we had a look at the Bushcraft Show, a few of the stalls, and see what was going on. And to be honest, I wasn't overly impressed, but I think that was mainly because of the weather. It was absolutely pissing down all day, and it just made everything really miserable, and I just couldn't be bothered doing anything. Just wanted to get warm, get dry, and chill. So we did that, but then persevered, and we all sort of knuckled down together and started improving camp, chopping wood, processing it, you know, making brews and stuff, and just doing a bit of work. And I think as a reward, the sun's come out and it's absolutely beautiful now. It's really nice and sunny, and hopefully it'll dry up some of these paths as well, but we'll see. But yeah, really nice. So back off to the arena, go and have a look around and see what's what. Anyway guys, I'll catch you later. Okay, so I'm at the show with Zed Outdoors. So Zed, how do you feel about the show so far?
Do you know what? It's been great. The rain kind of hampered it a little bit on the Saturday morning, but we still kind of stuck through it. But now, man, you wouldn't even think it was raining.
It's beautiful. Shades on, sun's out.
Yeah, and I'm trying to look the part.
So,
even if I can't do it, at least I look the part.
You didn't have the shave for the occasion, did you? A little beard trim.
I know. I'm trying to look dapper, man. Yeah, a little kind of dollop of aftershave.
Got to look good for your videos, yeah.
Yeah, I know, man. I've got to look all good for my audience. So,
So what's the plan for tomorrow then?
Plan for today is just have a walk around with yourself, your delightful self. And then what we're going to do is just have a little walk around, go with the flow, grab something to eat, and have dinner tonight. And then tomorrow, myself, just like what you're doing now, try to shoot a lot of video. So there's a lot of guys here I'm going to speak to individually and do that. So today's kind of wrecking it out. So a lot of it's kind of weather dependent as well. So that's why now, that's why we're just kind of trying to make the most of it, get out and stuff, you know. So the moment we saw the blue skies, that was it. Quickly grab that stuff and let's go, you know. But so far it's been great. I'm really, really looking forward to it.
Brilliant. So just been to see the Maasai tribe doing the thing.
I'm sure I've seen these guys before. Weren't they busking in Chester City Centre last year?
Chester City Centre. I swear I saw him there. Right next to the cathedral.
How's that booking?
Yeah. Morning YouTube. Sunday now. Sunday morning. I had a really good night's sleep last night. Really cosy and warm. The only trouble is it rained an awful lot last night. So the conditions on the Bushcraft Show site is even worse. And I've found out that the Bushcraft Show have actually said to the day visitors visiting on the Sunday, basically just not bother coming because it's just so wet and boggy, it just wasn't worth it. And they were offering refunds to anyone who's bought a day ticket for today, so they just said, just don't bother. So, but I'll give you an idea of how boggy it is actually. I'll just turn you around, have a look at this. Guys, well, unfortunately that's the last of the footage that I got from the Bushcraft Show. I had to leave early on the Sunday because I had other commitments for the Monday, so I couldn't stay for the final day, unfortunately. But had a fantastic time, really, really good. What can I say? It's a good show. Unfortunately the weather was a bit miserable and the venue and the facilities was a bit of a joke, so you know, hopefully for the next year's one we can improve on that. But we made the most of it, you know, there's nothing you can do about the weather, so we no, it was great. Yeah, so it was a big shame that I had to leave. You know, there's another whole day to explore the show, but you know, things happened and I had to go early. So I mean, all the guys were saying, "Oh no, come on, stay, you know, don't go, you know, can't you just stay one more night, you know, stay another day." And then by complete coincidence, on the journey home in the car, this happened. I just want to say a massive thank you to all the guys I was with. You know, Zed Outdoors, what can I say, top bloke. You know, he invited me down to the shelter. I wouldn't have done it, being able to go without you really, because I mean, I've never really met any other YouTubers before. I've only had a couple that I've been contacting and emailing and things like that. And it was, yeah, he invited me along and said, yeah, come and stay with us. And in the group shelter, we had a parachute. So yeah, thank you so much. You know, your hospitality, you're just so friendly and welcoming. And I must say as well, that curry we had on the Friday night was fantastic. So yeah. All the guys I was with as well. Sparky Steve, great guy, another top bloke. Oh, and Mrs. Sparky Steve's cake was absolutely out of this world. I mean, I'm not a big cake fan, but that was just superb. Best cake I've had in a long time, so thank you, Mrs. Sparky Steve. We had Hunterian 1986 as well, another top guy. And also we had Wessex Blades stay with us. He came down on the Friday evening, about 9 o'clock, just in time for the curry. He's another top guy, you know, he... giving some really good tips on axe work and blade work, and fantastic. So, what did I expect to achieve from going to the Bushcraft Show? Well, to be honest with you, I wasn't too fussed about all the stalls and the sales, sort of tents and things like that. I mean, I've got an awful lot of gear as it is, and to be honest, a lot of it was quite overpriced. You know, you can get it an awful lot cheaper on the internet. What I was there for was I wanted to experience the whole YouTube community and get to meet people. I mean, I didn't really know anyone from YouTube other than, you know, online contact. It was fantastic to meet people face to face, you know, have a brew and just chew the fat and get to know people. And I really feel part of that community now. You can really get a sense of like a brotherhood within this community of YouTubers. And it's just fantastic. Everybody was so friendly and warm and kind, and it's just really good. I can't wait till the next one. Hopefully I'll be going to the Wilderness Gathering. If not, there'll be the 100 Preppers Meetup. Apparently there's another one in September time, so I'll be coming to that. But yeah, top weekend. But anyway guys, so it's been good, and I'll see you in the next one.